everybody. I hope you're doing well. Stay safe. Stay healthy.
Hi, everyone. Miss you all.
Good to see you. Hello. How are you? Yeah.
Hi, y'all. Miss you all, too. God bless you. See you soon.
Hello, and welcome to worship with St. Paul's United Methodist Church of Mendota Heights, Minnesota. I'm Amy Jo Burr, the pastor of St. Paul's, and I welcome you to join us in worship today. Especially, we want to welcome Owen Patrick Young, who will be baptized as part of our worship service today. It is the joy of the church to welcome new people to the family of faith through the sacrament of baptism. So we celebrate with joy along with Owen and his family today. Second, I want to extend a special word of welcome and hospitality to all of our neighbors at Christ United Methodist Church who are joining us in worship today. Pastor Jenny's vacation was unexpectedly extended due to unforeseen weather conditions where she was vacationing in the state of Texas. Pastor Jenny is safe. She will be home soon. We miss her. But until then, we're so glad that you chose to join us in worship. Before we begin, I have just a couple of words of announcement. The first is that during this Lenten season, the Adult Education Group will be hosting a video conference called Come Dream Together. This is a video conference in which the people can share together their dreams, their hopes, and their aspirations in order to lift one another up. We think this will be a very inspirational video conference, and if you wish to participate, tomorrow is the last day for registration, so please contact Diane in the St. Paul's office and she will get you registered and send you a video link for that group. Second, if you are a youth or child within the St. Paul's United Methodist Church family, you should have already received delivered to your home a devotional kit for the weeks of Lent. We thank Lonnie for putting together these beautiful kits, And if for any reason you did not receive yours, please contact the church office and we will get one out to you. And finally, I want to remind everyone that registration is open for United Methodist camping opportunities for the summer. And I already found out camps are filling up quickly, even at this time of year. So if you're interested in camping this summer, registration is open and you can contact the church office for more information or go to Camps Minnesota and register right there online on the Minnesota United Methodist Church's website. Finally, I want to say thank you to all who contribute generously and financially to the mission of St. Paul's United Methodist Church. Your giving makes a life in the difference of many. I always like to stop and think about all of the ways that our giving affects people, and announcing registration for camps beginning reminds me that part of our apportionment dollars are spent in support of our three camping ministries in the United Methodist Church in Minnesota. There is Camp Coronas at Painesville, Northern Pines Camp in Park Rapids, and Kewaukin Adventures in Ely. All three of these sites help with Christian formation and discipleship in especially our young people, but in people of every age. So if you have not participated in one of our camping or retreat ministries, I hope you have a chance to do so. And for all who have given faithfully and generously to support the mission of the church, your dollars have made a difference in the life of many young campers whose faith has blossomed and bloomed at church camp. Let's begin our worship time now with a word of prayer. Won't you please join me in this prayer? This prayer was originally written by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. O God, our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for the inspiration of Jesus the Christ, who came to this world to show us the way. And grant that we will see in that life the fact that we are made for that which is high and noble and good. Help us to live in line with that high calling, that great destiny. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Please join me in the singing of our opening hymn, Holy, Holy, Holy. Words will appear on the screen so you can sing along, and Lane will lead us in the singing.
Morning, a song shall rise to Thee.
Hi, kids. In today's Bible passage, Jesus talks about how the kingdom of God is like yeast that was mixed in with 3 measures of flour until the whole loaf was leavened. Now, most of our families at St. Paul's usually get their bread from the store, already baked. But in the time when Jesus told this story, everyone would have known what yeast is and what yeast does because they made their own bread. And so yeast is the part of the bread that causes it to rise and grow bigger. So what do you think Jesus meant by the kingdom of God is like yeast that gets mixed in with grain until the whole loaf is leavened? I'm going to give you a couple of guesses about what maybe Jesus meant. I think he could have meant that the kingdom of God is always rising and getting bigger and expanding because we invite more people to be part of it and we tell more people about God. I think it could also be that he was talking about how the kingdom of God causes our hopes to rise. Like when you're feeling down or sad and someone says something that lifts you up, that's what you say, yeast makes things rise. So I thought today we could make a couple of loaves of bread and see what yeast does. So I have here with me a couple of bowls. They both have grain in them. And they are each going to make 1 loaf of bread. In 1 loaf of bread, I'm going to put yeast. In the other, I won't. And we'll see what the yeast does for these loaves of bread. Now, this is yeast. Yeast is a tiny, tiny little organism. Looks kind of like grains of sand. So there's not much of it. And I am going to put 2 teaspoons of yeast in this bowl. There we go. And 0 teaspoons of yeast in this bowl. And after we finish baking them, we'll be able to see the difference that yeast makes for these 2 loaves of bread. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna add the wet ingredients and I'm going to knead the bread. That's when you stretch and fold and stretch and fold and stretch and fold and stretch and fold the bread. That helps the gluten develop. Then we'll let it rise and I'll put it in the oven and I'll be back in just a minute on this video to show you what the finished loaves look like. And the one on your left-hand side of the screen is the one that had the yeast. So I bet, my guess is, my prediction is that the one on the left-hand side of the screen is going to turn out risen up much bigger and fluffier. Just like the kingdom of God grows as we invite more people to be part of it. Let's see. Here we are with our finished loaves. This is the loaf into which we put the yeast. And this is the loaf without yeast. You can see how the yeast causes the whole loaf to rise. The kingdom of God is like yeast that mixed in causes the whole loaf to rise. We think about how our religion, Christianity, began with Jesus and 12 disciples, and now there are millions of Christians all around the world. The kingdom of God causes the whole loaf to rise and to grow. Our first scripture reading today is from Jeremiah 29, verses 11 through 14. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me if you seek me with all your heart. I will let you find me, says the Lord, and I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all the nations and all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord. And I will bring you back to the place from which I sent you into exile. Here ends the first reading. Our second scripture reading is from Matthew 13, verses 31 through 33 and 44 through 46. Jesus put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until all of it was leavened. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which someone found and hid. Then in his joy, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls. On finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. During the Lenten season, our adult education class is dreaming together. They're sharing their dreams, their hopes, and aspirations in order to inspire each other and lift each other up. Now, these dreams, hopes, and aspirations are filled with a bit of what the prophet Jeremiah describes in today's reading as a vision of a future with hope. A future with hope is what we all long for, and it was God's promise to the people in exile through the prophet Jeremiah. It is still God's promise today to provide us a future filled with hope. When we look towards God's future, we do see a future of hope. And when we listen to and when we read the parables of the coming kingdom of God, we see a vision laid out of that future with hope. And it's filled with growth, health, prosperity, beauty, and community. Now, today's parables, we read 4. One about a small seed that grows into a great plant that shelters birds and grows large. We read about yeast, a tiny, tiny organism that's mixed in with a great deal of flour and causes the whole loaf to rise. And then we read 2 parables about the value of the kingdom of God, one describing it as a fine pearl, the other describing it as a hidden treasure. And it talks about how on finding that hidden treasure, the person sold all that they had in order to buy that field. The coming kingdom of God is a thing of great value, and it is filled, as I said, with growth, with health, prosperity, beauty, and community. These types of dreams and visions have a great value to us. They have a value to motivate us and steer us toward a future with hope. Now, it's the teaching of the church that the kingdom of God is both a current and a future reality. And here's what I mean. The kingdom of God will never come to full fruition and be fully revealed until Christ comes again in final victory and we are all united together around God's table. But until that day, we do look forward to the kingdom of God coming, and we pray in the Lord's Prayer that it will be done, God's will, and that the kingdom of earth will come on earth as it is in heaven. And until that day, we begin to see glimpses here and there of the coming of kingdom of God, and we see them most clearly when the church is fully living out its mission, fully living out its dream for its community, fully living out love of God and neighbor in all that it does. Now, during this past year, I've heard many times when people have said that they feel kind of caught on a downward spiral. There have been enough difficulties in the world around us that we just feel like everything's going downhill. Have you had any days like that during this past year? Maybe one, maybe two, maybe more. If you've ever felt like you've been caught on that downward spiral, focusing on the kingdom of God can help to lift us up. And as we put forward, as the church pushes forward a vision of the coming kingdom of God, it can cause uplift in the whole community around us, because everyone in our community needs to feel the hope that lifts us out of a downward spiral and instead propels us toward a future with hope, the coming kingdom of God. Now, I said that little glimpses of the kingdom of God can be most clearly seen when the church is fulfilling its mission. And so whenever we serve, we see glimpses, and it builds in us a sense of hope. When we're providing emergency relief through our partners at Neighbors, Inc., when we're supporting Emma Norton Services or promoting literacy and friendship at Garlow, each of these things brings us a little bit closer to that coming vision and provides for us a vision of that future with hope. We dream of what our communities will be like when God's will is fully revealed. And we do have dreams every time we serve, right? We have a dream that everyone will have the food and housing that they need for today, that their basic needs will be met. And when we serve at Neighbors and Emma Norton, we're dreaming about these kinds of things, and we're working in mission with God's help and strength toward that day. We have a dream that the racial achievement gap will close in our Minnesota schools. And when we're volunteering at Garlow, we're taking another step forward towards seeing that dream become a reality. We have a dream of a time when refugees are going to be welcomed with the care that Deuteronomy teaches us. And we dream of a time when racial reconciliation brings peace between all nations. And when we serve together with immigrants, and when we tutor English language learners at our partner school, we begin to work with God's help and strength toward these days. God's kingdom truly is something of great value. And as God's people, we hope, pray, and work for the day when it will be fully realized. And until that day, our hopes are lifted and our strength is renewed by God's promise that there is a future with hope and that the kingdom of God is a thing of great value, filled with every beautiful thing. Let's pray together now. And the community prayer that I ask you to pray with me was it's from the United Methodist Book of Worship, and it's written by Wanda Lawrence, who is a Chippewa. It's part of her vision of what a world of peace might look like. Please join me in prayer. We pray that someday an arrow will be broken, not in something or someone, but by each of humankind, to indicate peace, not violence. Someday oneness with creation rather than domination over creation will be the goal to be respected. Someday fearlessness to love and make a difference will be experienced by all people. Then the eagle will carry our prayer for peace and love. And the people of the red, white, yellow, brown, and black communities can sit in the same circle together to communicate in love and experience the presence of the great mystery in their midst. Someday can be today. for you and me. Amen.
Greetings, Christ Church family. It's Pastor Jenny, and yes, I am still stuck in good old Tundra, Texas. But with that said, we have the assurance of God being with us through everything, and I have seen that in this experience. So I'm safe. We're in a place all hunkered down where they do have power and heat, so I'm grateful for that. And so with that said, I want to send up the Lord's Prayer for us and for you all. So pray with me, if you will. Our Father, Mother, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. God bless y'all. See you soon.
Oh, Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We're incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift, offered to us without price. Let us pray, blessing the baptismal waters together. Eternal Father, when nothing existed but chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth light. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water. After the flood, you set in the clouds a rainbow. When you saw your people as slaves in Egypt, you led them to freedom through the sea. Their children you brought through the Jordan to the land which you promised. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Tell of God's mercy each day. In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus, nurtured in the water of Mary's womb. He was baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection, and to make disciples of all nations. Declare his works to the nations, his glory among all people. Pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and Owen who receives it, to wash away his sin and clothe him in righteousness throughout his life, that dying and being raised with Christ, he may share in Christ's final victory. All praise to you, eternal Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever. Amen. Will Owen and his family please come forward today? Wyatt, you want to come up too? For yourself, so I'm going to ask them to Mom and Dad to answer on your behalf. All right? Does that work? Give me a thumbs up. Okay. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of the world, and repent of your sin? If so, answer, I do. Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they may present themselves? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in his grace, and promise to serve him as your Lord in union with the church, which Christ has opened to people of all ages, all nations, and all races? If so, answer, I do. And now I ask all who are gathered here today and all who are joining us by video, will you nurture Owen in Christ's holy church, that by our teaching and example, he may be guided to accept God's grace for himself, to profess his faith openly, and to lead a Christian life? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
And to all of us, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both our rejection of sin and our commitment to Christ. If so, answer, we do.
We do.
All right, Owen. We believe God's grace is already reaching out to you. I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And now may the God of all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, establish you and strengthen you by the power of the Holy Spirit, that you may live in grace and peace. Amen. Now it is our joy to welcome our new brother in Christ, Owen Patrick Young. Owen, meet your church family. You know these people, right? Hallelujah. We are so glad for Owen becoming a part of the baptized members of St. Paul's United Methodist Church. Go in peace.
Please join me in the singing of our final hymn, Be Thou My Vision. Let us go with God's blessing. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.